Now, physical distancing rules have been relaxed despite Auckland staying at alert level 2.5 for at least another week. Yesterday, Labor leader Jacinda Ardern announced a short extension to the current levels, and it comes as new cases continue to pop up in Auckland, including a health worker at a quarantine facility and a child associated with the Botany subcluster and genomically linked to the Auckland cluster. To unpack the latest developments, we're joined by the Director General of Health, Dr. Ashley Bloomfield. Morena te rangatira, thank you so much for joining us this morning, Dr. Bloomfield. Really appreciate it. So can you talk us through the advice that you gave to the Prime Minister yesterday around the levels announcement and how contact tracing played a part in that?
Morena. So the advice yesterday around the alert levels, which was to Cabinet, was based on what we're seeing around the epidemiology of this outbreak in Auckland. We are seeing a drop in the number of cases, which is good. But we have, as you've said, had those cases just up in the last week or so. You've mentioned contact tracing, and I think that's been one of the features of our response to this Auckland outbreak, is that our contact tracing has happened very quickly, which has been good. We've been able to get people isolated and tested very quickly, those who are close contacts. And we've also extended that out to those, as we call, contacts of contacts, just to be doubly sure. So we've used that through the outbreak, and that's what we're continuing to do, which is part of our plan to, again, try and move down alert levels as quickly as possible. But the advice yesterday was we don't think it's the time to do that quite yet.
I want to talk about the risk of Aucklanders travelling, because there seems to be some discrepancy about the risk of Aucklanders travelling around the country. So Winston Peters, in a statement on the his New Zealand First website, said the Director General of Health has stated that the COVID-19 outbreak in Auckland is contained. Additionally, he believes there is a low risk of transmission outside of Auckland. Now, the Prime Minister said yesterday, modelling done for the Ministry of Health continues to suggest around a 25% chance of cases moving outside of the Auckland region. So, first of all, is the cluster contained?
Yes, we're confident the cluster is contained. And as the Deputy Prime Minister said, indeed, there is a low risk of cases outside of Auckland, but there's not no risk. And if you look, in fact, at the rest of the North Island outside of Auckland, there's about, at the moment, the modelling is showing still a 30 to 40% possibility of a case outside of Auckland being seeded from someone travelling out of Auckland, and around a 10 to 20% likelihood in the South Island. A lot of people have talked about, well, why can't the South Island go to alert level one? So, yes, there is a lower risk in the South Island, but it's not no risk. And these extra few days will just help reduce that risk even further. And it will have given us a couple of weeks to detect if any cases have been seeded outside of Auckland or in the South, and particularly in the South Island.
The physical distancing rules have been relaxed on public transport and also on planes. Were there any consideration given to other spaces, like, for instance, theatre productions?
Well, at the moment, the big change, of course, in public transport and on aircraft is that compulsory use of face covering during alert level two. And so that was one of the key issues we were keeping an eye on. And the fact that there's been very high uptake and cooperation with that expectation means that we felt it was time now we could reduce that physical distancing requirement. And remembering also, people are usually on public transport or on flights for a relatively short period of time, whereas often they might be in another setting like a theatre or let's say in a restaurant or a bar where they're not wearing masks, but actually they're there for longer. There's a lot more interacting, talking and so on going on. So the physical distancing requirements we think need to be maintained in those settings.
Dr. Bloomfield, we have to wrap things up, but I do want to ask you, we learned yesterday that a child has the virus. Professor Michael Baker is wanting masks to be worn in schools. So what's your position on that?
Well, we're guided by the World Health Organization advice on, and that is that face coverings and masks are not recommended to children age 12. And yes, there was a child yesterday, and we have had a number of children who have been infected through this outbreak. In fact, the child yesterday was not symptomatic at all, suggesting they're not that infected. So we think we've got the settings about right, and we keep looking at the advice from the WHO all the time.
E te matua, Dr. Ashley Bloomfield, thank you so much for your time this morning. We really do appreciate it. The Director General of Health. Tēnā koe.
Kia ora.